drivers often use handbrakes to rotate a car around a sharp turn. It's a very personal decision that makes the location of the handbrake very personal as well. Here's a few examples.
While Ken is signing autographs for his fans, what I want to point out is what's going on inside the car. Alex is getting ready for the next day of rallying, but the handbrake that Ken has in the car is different than practically any other handbrake that you'll see, largely because of the gear shift, the paddle shifts that are up on the close to the steering wheel. That means that the handbrake has to be close to the paddle shift to make the whole thing work. Alex Gelsomino, Ken's co-driver, how often does he use that handbrake in order to make all this work?
Only on very tight hairpins, you know, you just use it to break loose the back and let the car turn around quickly. But otherwise, on very fast flowing corners or even technical parts of the stages, you don't use it. It doesn't use the
hairpin. Does it ever get in the way of you, or you ever get in the way of it when he has to use it?
No, not really. You know, a few years of working together, we know that we have our own space in the car, and we don't interfere with the other guys.
It's a nice dance.
Yeah. So sometimes, yeah, we do bump into each other, but it's more like elbows, you know.
This is the number 40 Subaru of BMX legend Dave Mira. You can see how he has his handbrake right by the gear shift lever. It makes sense. He could go right from here to here and do the whatever he needs to do on it. I can see it's hooked up. But it's simple. One simple move from the gear shift lever to the handbrake. Bill Bacon, you put your handbrake right next to the gear shift, which seems to be the most common, but you said that you almost don't use it at all.
We don't really use it as much as we had anticipated. We come from a two-wheel drive, front-wheel drive car, where you have to use the hydraulic handbrake a lot to rotate the car. And with the all-wheel drive, the car, it will really come around on its own under power. So I had contemplated putting it even closer than this, so it was going to be the first thing I could grab. I talked to a few people that run the same sort of car, and we put it a little further away maybe than some of the other guys have it, and so far I don't regret it.
Jimmy Keeney, you were the 2009 Super Production Champion. You didn't even use the handbrake until later in the season.
Yeah, we never found much of a use for it other than maybe a hard one or a two corner, you know, and it was always, we just found a way to not use it so we can keep the tires spinning and stuff like that. A lot of my hill climb racing, I used to drive two-wheel drive, so I never, you know, I could always just pitch the car around the corner, so I got used to doing that with this. We got the X Games running on asphalt, and I wasn't able to pitch the car. So we called up Reese Millen and Stefan Verdier, and they hooked us up with a handbrake out of Reese's drift car. When we were at X Games, we didn't have a lot of tools or choice on things. So I kind of found a spot it would mount in the car where our brake lines would let us do it and where everything would work, and it's just kind of where it stayed. So I put a shorter handle on it just to keep it out of the way.